welcome to my channel, my well-being pal. My name is Lee, and this is the last video in the series of videos on the chakras and the hormone glands. Okay, so this is the seventh chakra, which is the crown chakra. Okay, which is the color of violet, my favorite color, and my favorite oil as well, lavender. And it is really anything to do with the I am presence, anything to do with, you know, who we are at this deep soul level. Now, this is a big one for me. I would have suffered many, many headaches over the years. And, you know, really, the only way I've been able to really solve it, I mean, I looked at food and I reduced things like dairy and really anything. You know, what I did was I honed it down to the estrogen and bringing the estrogen balance into the system. And I'll come back to that in a wee second because it's very, very relevant for this crown chakra. Okay, just turn that music down a little bit. And today, if you're just finding me for the first time, there's other videos that look at all the chakras. Today we're looking at the crown. We talk a little bit about it and then we do a lovely meditation to help bring it into balance. Okay? And amethyst would be the crystal, this beautiful amethyst for the chakra. So if you have an amethyst or you love crystals, get one of these. I would have actually just had one of these when I had a headache, just sitting literally on my head when I was meditating, lying down. And this in Sanskrit language, okay, is Sahasrara, okay, and it means thousand fold petal. Okay, so one of the things that I would do is actually imagine this beautiful lotus flower opening up in the crown of my head. And that's actually one of the symbols in my branding, is a beautiful lotus flower as well. Okay, and whenever I first did, I was very guided whenever we were first went into lockdown to do a full week of Facebook, Instagram lives on each of these chakras. Okay. And funny enough, it was the crown chakra, you know, fell on Easter Sunday, I think it fell on. Which was very significant, okay? Because, you know, as I talked earlier about estrogen balance, estrogen comes from the word Easter. And that's linked into the egg, okay? And I have with me this beautiful book, this Mary Magdalene Revealed by Megan Watterson. And this is the first apostle, her feminist gospel and the Christianity we haven't yet tried. And this is one of the books that I would highly, highly recommend. It is probably one of the best books I've ever read. And it really, you know, helps me to connect with the energy of Mary Magdalene, all right? Mary Magdalene being this powerful woman, this powerful female feminine energy, this goddess energy. And particularly page 98, where she talks about the egg. And I'm just going to read a little bit of this out just. And this is actually where she has quoted this from somebody else, Lane Redmond, and in their book, When the Women Were Drummers. All the eggs a woman will ever carry form in her ovaries. When she's a four-month-old fetus in the womb of her mother. This means our cellular life as an egg begins in the womb of our grandmother. Each of us spent 5 months in our grandmother's womb. And it's really interesting because my daughter took her period for the first time. She's 11 last week. And I had a bleed and I'm not due until like today or tomorrow. So it was like a week early, but it didn't come. It was just like a bleed. And that was me connecting with my daughter. And that's the first thing I thought about when she had her period. She can now have children, and that is my grandchild. And literally, I just sat with that whenever I connected with these words, and I just thought that was so, so beautiful. Now, the egg is connected to Mary Magdalene, okay? And Mary Magdalene would be connected with Easter, okay? So Mary Magdalene, Christ resurrected to Mary Magdalene, okay, in the tomb. All right, and the egg is connected to, so what Mary and Magdalene did, this, you know, and it's like an ancient legend, okay, where the egg is associated with Easter. She traveled over to Rome, where she met Julius Caesar to try and explain the story of Christ, her love for Christ, how he was purely the pure injustice of it all. And she told Caesar that Christ had risen. Okay, now the egg is to do with, you know, an egg is like obviously like an egg shape. It's like beginnings and endings. Okay, and funny, I've just done a video this week about the energy for this week, and it's very much about death and rebirth. We're in this is Monday the 18th of May. Okay, and I just wanted to read this out to you. Okay, so when we start, when we are born, okay, there is dark, and we're within the womb, which is very, very dark, and our only light is our soul, okay? So this new life that awaits to emerge from within, the soul is the beginning and also the end. Birth is meant to happen before we die, ideally many times, okay? So this is what happens to us when we go through this process of awakening, and this is one of the reasons why I'm doing these, you know, free videos, to help people understand that yes, there's this physical body via the hormone glands and your physical symptoms, but there's also the emotional body, the spiritual body, and they're very much connected, and very much we need to understand both, because we go through this death and rebirth process many times in our lives, and it can feel very, very heavy in our body, and it can feel, you know, we're very much detoxing. And if we don't understand that, we can think there's something serious wrong with us, okay? I'm not saying this is always the case. Always get medical conditions checked out with the doctor. I'm just giving you another perspective on physical and emotional well-being, okay? So, but we have to die to let to the ego, to let this birth and rebirth process take hold, okay? The more the soul rises and resurrects this life, the more love is present here inside us. Meaning the soul is all we are when we come into this life, and it's all we will be when we leave it, okay? And, you know, this is where, at this point, when Mary Magdalene was in front of Caesar and was talking about how Jesus had, you know, resurrected, this was his words, "Hi, yeah, right. A person can no more resurrect than that egg in your hand can turn red." Guess what happened? The egg turned red. Okay, so I thought that was a really, really beautiful to talk about, you know, this crown chakra and the pineal hormone gland today. Okay, because it's all to do with estrogen balance in the brain. Okay, and the physical and conditions, obviously, I've said headaches. So anything neurological around the head in the brain, lack of sleep. Okay, the pineal gland governs sort of our third eye, okay? Just pulled a wee card here. So this is the same lady that wrote this, Megan Watterson, has a beautiful card deck called the Divine Feminine. They're very, very deep cards. This is our card, okay? So Fatima, okay? The mother, okay? So love is my lineage and gratitude to my religion. So that's a really beautiful card to get. I'm also gonna pull another card for another energy just to see what else wants to come in. And so any the conditions around this where there's an estrogen balance, as I said, headaches, but you can also get things like fibroids, endometriosis, cellulite, thyroid problems, breast lumps, libido problems, okay? And very much this is connected to the element, okay? They're all connected to elements, all the different chakras and hormone glands, and this one is pure consciousness. So it's having that awareness of there's something more. And with this, obviously, 2020 vision and what's been going on with this virus at the minute, a lot of us are really awakening up and remembering that there's something more than the physical, okay? And it's seeing everything from that higher perspective, okay? So it's all about this I am presence, you know, looking at the word perfection, wisdom, purpose, consciousness, and understanding, okay? Taking a break to trust the way you came. You came into this world and into this time, and that time is not running out, okay? And we are spiritual beings having a human experience, okay? Which is a beautiful quote from Deepak Chopra I wrote here, okay? When this is out of balance, when this chakra, this hormone gland is out of balance, we can feel very disconnected, very worried, concerned, concerned about physical stuff, material stuff, What are people thinking of me? Things like that, okay? But we can also spiritually escape if this is an area that's out of balance, okay? So we can meditate too much. We can be too much in this spiritual woo-woo world. So it's very important to be balanced in both, okay? And I've just pulled a couple of cards here. So we have Radha, very deep cards we have today, which is all about soul flame and rediscovering that lost part of yourself. Experience, relation, harmony and healing. And that's a perfect card because as I'm filming this, Venus, the planet of love and relationships, is in retrograde. So this is, and this chakra and this hormone gland is all connected in with the I am, who you really are, and knowing who you are. And when you know who you are, this is connected to your base chakra, okay? This connects all of them, all right? You won't have any, an overload of physical symptoms which are trying to get your attention to bring you back into balance again, okay? So I'm just popping those on. We also have Lady Nada, which is all about the heart. And if you imagine the heart is the bridge between, the three upper chakras and the three lower chakras, three upper hormones, three lower hormones, okay? The thymus gland, okay? And that's a really beautiful one too for self-love, for acceptance and who you are. Okay, so what else? It really connects heaven and earth. So oils, lavender, cedarwood, frankincense, myrrh, neroli, vetiver, all my favorites. Generally what I do, actually, I just love lavender, and what I would do if I have a headache is I would actually brush lavender through my hair. Doterra lavender oils, because of the quality of them. But I would also, frankincense would be a big one, and I would put a drop under my tongue, Doterra brand, and also one drop into the palm of my hands, and I would massage it into my facial moisturizer as well, okay? And it really helps. Frankincense helps with any inflammation, any neurological conditions, seizures, trauma, all of that type of stuff, okay? What else? I've said some of this stuff, so I'm just checking if I've left anything out. Yeah, eating foods containing B6 is really good for balance and estrogen. Salmon, tuna, banana, walnuts, sweet potato and beans. And also reducing the xenoestrogens in the body, which is a lot of chemicals, the soaps that you'll use, your shampoo, your facial washes, your cleaning products. So that's where I use essential oils. There's another video on down about how I use essential oils, and I'll be doing more of those. And I have a little oil group called My Well Oiled Life on Facebook if anybody wants to follow me there or join the group. I do a lot of stuff in there on how to make different products with your essential oils. So I would make like a kitchen surface cleaner, I'll make like an energy spray, like a bed spray, I'll make like a deodorant, I'll make like a facial oil, body oil, facial wash, things like that, okay? Just to try and reduce the level of toxins in the body to help balance the hormones so it's not such a toxic load on the body. Also stress is a big one, big massive one, okay? So stress, reducing stress. So that's why we'll always do a meditation with these videos to help reduce stress. And the oils really do that. So they activate a part in the emotional part of the brain that can only be activated via smell. So they're helping just to calm. And obviously lavender is the oil for relaxation as well, okay? And it's also the oil for communication. And I find a lot of us, particularly women, as we sort of awaken to the truth of who we are, we can find that we have lost that voice. And we're just sort of doing everything for everybody else. So it's just really, really important to have that voice and find that voice and speak your truth, which is easier said than done. Okay, so the lavender really helps with that. What else? So lovely affirmation. So this is a beautiful affirmation. And what I might do is I might read this at the end of the meditation when your eyes are closed. And I've also wrote some questions to contemplate. So if you want to grab a wee journal after this video and answer some of these questions, I will put them in the video, so you don't have to like rush to write them now. You can still stay in your meditation and then afterwards answer them, but still staying in that meditative place. Okay, so we will start. Just put some music on. Getting yourself nice and comfortable. seated. If you fall asleep during meditations, I would sit. Or lying down if you need a lovely relaxation session. This energy center, the crown chakra, also connects with the color violet, which is the violet flame, which helps with any drama, any negativity. So if there has been a lot of stress in your life, this is the perfect one to end on, the perfect one to just come back to every week, every day, whenever you need it. So I'm sitting cross-legged. I'm just going to allow us to roll our necks, just to loosen this area. Keeping your eyes closed, and you're going to do lovely neck rolls. Arching forward and back and forward and back, and you can do some shoulder shrugs. You can also just put your hands through your hair just to stimulate the nerve endings and the meridians in the head. Through your nose, hold it for a second, then breathe out nice and deeply for six, out through your mouth. And you're wanting to catch the glottis in the throat. Catch, it's like a deep yogic breath to allow your body to sink into that parasympathetic nervous system of rest and digest. Imagine this beautiful lotus flower on the top of your head in your mind's eye. As you're breathing in, you're going to imagine it opening up this beautiful violet color, and you're going to allow that beautiful violet light in through your head. It's like a purple rain, Prince song. It's like a purple violet rain coming in through your head. And also the element of water is connected with flow. Getting you into your flow is connected with cleansing. It's connected with clearing the way for the light to come in. And as we're connecting with this light, I can feel do some semicircles with your hips just to connect with the womb area, the base chakra. So these two areas are connected. So we're just doing lovely circles with our eyes closed. We're still in this meditation. We're just doing a bit of a move and meditation to start with. And then go the other way. Just moving that energy. And I want you to try and do a figure of eight. Just your visualizing a figure of eight. Between the two ovaries, the two pineal glands, the left and the right. So you have the two pineal glands in the brain, two ovaries in the base. Also the two adrenal glands connected with stress. The two chambers of the heart. Connected with our soul. You allow this beautiful purple mist to come over your face. It's going to go right into your brain, cleansing and clearing on a deep cellular level, flushing any toxins down through the body and out through the soles of the feet, deep into Mother Earth. Thank you. People in my life are here to teach me something about myself so that I can grow. I trust that everything happens for a reason and what I do makes a difference. I am balanced between heaven and earth, and all areas of my life are in balance too. So just connect with the word balance, connect with the infinity symbol in the brain, come down into the heart, come down into the adrenals, and in the base. And I'm going to pause between each question, if you can keep your eyes closed. And I want you to contemplate the answer and ask to be shown the answer. Go with the first thing that comes into your head. You can connect your left hand to your heart and your right hand to your womb if you wish, or the other way around. What people, things, or situations do I consciously or unconsciously try to control? People, things, or situations do I consciously or unconsciously try to control? Remember, we're now in the flow in of the water energy. Letting go of control, surrender, and going with the flow. What if I recognize that control is an illusion? What if I recognize that control is an illusion? How can I surrender to life? How can I surrender to life? What steps can I take after this? Is there any part of me, whether physical, emotional, or spiritual, that I can feel needs additional healing at this time? Is there any part of me, and as I say these words, whether physical, and feel that in your physical body, is there any part being shown, emotional, in your emotional body, or spiritual, that I feel needs additional healing at this time? And how, lastly, can I offer more love and care to that place? What words do I need to say about myself or about others? Do I need to meditate? Do I need to touch myself more with massage and the oils? Do I need to eat more good food? What self-care practices could I adopt? Do I need more time for me? Do I need to meditate more? Do I need more baths? Do I need to do more yoga, more walking, more listening to or reading books? Maybe it's more baking, maybe it's more playing with the children. Maybe it's drawing. Maybe it's gardening, maybe it's decluttering, maybe it's cleaning. Just ask to be shown to take a wee minute before I close. You're very welcome then to open up your journals after this and write what's coming into your head. Gently open your eyes. I'm going to show you this symbol.